Hey everyone, Steph here. We're about halfway through the summer and we've just been so crazy busy. I also have really crazy allergies going on right now, if you can't tell. There's a lot of farms where I live and it's so bad right now, and this is actually a good day for me, even with my red eyes and yeah, watery eyes. Anyways, so this summer's been really busy. And this last week has been especially crazy. We had three different sets of company come from out of town. One stayed here at my house, one was at my grandma's, so we went out to my grandma's house, and one was at my in-law's house, so we were over there. Plus, we had a ton of appointments, and this last week was just crazy. So I wanted to make a video because you know what I didn't do last week? I didn't do my home lesson. I did probably 50% of my morning routine days, and I think I barely did my evening routine at all, just starting the dishwasher and that's it. So my laundry has piled up again. My house is just not in its state that I like. So I wanted to make this video to just show you that, you know, if you've ever been a secret slob before like I was, or you're just a normal person that gets overwhelmed, it's super likely that you'll have weeks like this where things just kind of fall apart. Some things are becoming quicker and more automatic, but a lot of things are still things I have to remind myself to do. So when everything else in life kind of piles up, guess what goes first? A lot of my routines and a lot of my cleaning habits. So I just wanted to talk about getting back on track after a crazy week. So back on track today. I woke up this morning, I was like, okay, here we go. Finally, a bit of a normal day. We're gonna get back on track. Someone asked us to go do something and I said, no, you know, we're just gonna chill. My kids need a break. They're kind of overwhelmed from all the company. I'm overwhelmed, plus my allergies are crazy. So when you fall off track, first things first, don't worry about it. It happens to everybody. So just give yourself a break. It's not a big deal. Second, I always like to get out my control journal and just get a blank sheet of paper and write a to-do list for the day. It just helps me really visualize exactly what I have to do, because a lot of times when your house gets out of control, it feels like you don't even know where to start and it's just crazy. So if you have a list, it just kind of itemizes what there is to do and shows you there's not that much to do. So first things first, let's just go through the day. It's early in the morning here and I wanted to make this video first thing just to show you how I'm getting back on track. So I'm just gonna quickly jot down my morning routine. So dishes, bed, laundry, swish and swipe, and get dressed to shoes, which I've already done. The next thing I'm gonna do is my weekly home blessing hour. The third thing I'm gonna do is when I run around and do my morning routine this morning and my home blessing, I'm gonna take my laundry baskets with me. And this is a tip I've seen a ton in the comments on my videos, is just taking a box or a laundry basket with you from room to room, picking up things that don't belong in that room, or for me, laundry. We seem to have a problem with just dumping laundry everywhere. And then as you move from room to room, putting it back where it belongs. So this works really well when your house like mine has just gotten a bit out of control. So now I've got my list, and if you look, it's not so bad. You know, I've got four things for my morning routine, five things for my weekly home blessing, so it's only nine things. So even though my house feels super overwhelming right now, it's just nine things, nine little check marks. I should be able to do this all in about an hour and a half, and my house will be back, and then I'll just carry on exactly where I left off. So I'm gonna do that and I'll just bring you along with me, and you can see my house isn't perfect. I've had kind of an off week and I'll just get it all together. Okay, so first things first, I always like to start in my kitchen. I don't know why, it just feels like the place to start. So I have some breakfast dishes there, and like I said, I didn't even start my dishwasher last night, which is super frustrating now, but hey, we're getting it done. My daughter took a super keen interest in doing the dishes, so she actually took over. She's only 3 and a half, and this is the first time she's ever done it, but she did a really good job. So I just cleaned up the rest of the kitchen, and she did the dishes, and her sister helped. Then I moved into the bathroom and she was still keen to help me, so she's doing the garbages, which is something she has done before. I opened the bag for her, but you can see she spreads it out. So I'm just doing my swish and swipe and my garbages and mirrors at the same time. I always do this on the Monday because it gives me two of my weekly home blessing chores done at the same time as my swish and swipe.
So as I move through my house, I just bring my little laundry baskets around. One takes toys and one takes laundry. And there wasn't actually a lot of stuff that was downstairs that needed to be put downstairs. It's mostly toys in my house and laundry. My kids are outside. They often come inside and take wet or muddy clothes off at the door. So I think I probably need to set up a few more laundry baskets around the house to conquer that. But these are things I'm just learning. So for now, I've just done this. I've run everything upstairs. And my downstairs is good to go. So I'm swish and swiping in my upstairs bathroom, changing these garbages, and my daughter's still helping me. She's got the little garbage there and she's wondering what to do with it. And she brought the paper towel to do the swish and swipe. It's just, this is one of the funnest days I've had. I couldn't believe she was super interested in helping. She even wanted to wear an apron. She's so cute. So then I come into my bedroom. Again, I don't make my bed on Mondays because I just strip the sheets off and I take them into the laundry. And that's my one load of laundry I do on Mondays. So as she does the garbage there, I'm just picking up laundry that I've left in my bathroom. I probably need to put a basket there since there's always a pile. Bringing it all into the laundry room, stripping the sheets off my daughter's beds, pulling the sheets from our bed, and that is all I'm going to do today.
Okay, I'm all done. Well, I'm done what I'm gonna do this morning. So I got my morning routine, I got half of my weekly home blessing, I got the sheets off the beds, I got the garbages changed and the mirrors done. So all I have left to do is mop, sweep, and dust, which I'll probably do when my kids are napping this afternoon. I had my kids running around helping me, getting into things. You know, just work your way through it as best you can. Good enough is good enough. Doing something is better than doing nothing. Really, even if you are just starting for the first time or restarting, like I kind of had to do a little mini restart today, just get started. Work your way through the little morning routine, work your way through whatever day we're on, home blessing, whatever, and evening routine, and try not to do more than that because it will come. My house doesn't look as great as it normally does, but it looks better than it did first thing this morning. So I'm glad about that, and I'm glad to be back on track. It really does feel like my routines are starting to become my home. Anyways, last thing, on to my big announcement. So if you didn't notice today, or maybe you noticed in one of my other videos, a couple people have busted me. I am pregnant, yay! I'm expecting my third baby, and I'm about 12 weeks along now, and I have a little bump. And I know it was a little bit more obvious in my last video, and so a couple people messaged me and said, congratulations, and I kind of didn't say anything. But yes, I'm pregnant and having another baby, so we're super excited. This pregnancy has been hard. My first two were super easy, total walk in the park. I was like, I'm killing this, I'll have like six more kids. This one has been rough, and I don't know if I'm having a boy, we have two girls, or maybe just because it's my third pregnancy, or because I'm having to chase two other kids around, but oh man, I was so sick, and my allergies are just crazy, and I've been sleeping like 14 or 15 hours a day. So that's a lot of the reason why I haven't really been doing my videos, and you haven't really seen much of me, is I am just hanging on by a thread, and my husband has been awesome. He was cooking and cleaning, and even for a while there I was so sick I didn't even want to go to the grocery store and look at food, so he has really taken over. But now I'm kind of coming out of that first trimester feeling good, feeling back to myself, which is so awesome, and I'm actually excited to start cleaning my house and cooking food again because I just hate it when I wasn't feeling good and I just felt like I couldn't do anything. So that is my big announcement. I'm expecting my third baby. We're so excited, and I will keep you updated with all of my cleaning stuff, and we're gonna keep going with food prep and meal planning later this month. But if you don't see me, just know I'm probably having a very long nap. I will talk to you all soon. Have a great day. Bye.